Well, hello everyone, this is Alfredo's Gaming, and today I will be looking at, driving and reviewing the Just Trains Class 222 add-on and the Just Trains Derby-Nottingham-Leicester route add-on. I'll be driving a Class 222 double from Leicester to Nottingham, or, well, yes, Leicester to Nottingham, so I hope you enjoy. Right, so here we are. I am going to go from Derby to Nottingham, even though I've just said I'm doing something else, because I haven't planned this video out at all. So, Derby to Nottingham, Meridian, let's go. Well, this should be fun. Hope you enjoy. Well, here we are. Derby, bound for Nottingham. Well, I have not driven the Midland Main Line variant of this train yet. First of all, can I say, this train looks amazing. It looks very realistic. So I'm very pleased with that, because it's my local train, and it's also my favourite train. But I think, personally, that the sounds let it down a little bit when it's accelerating, and also the horn. Like, inside, the horn doesn't even sound like a horn, it sounds like this. Well, I better get the train set up. Actually looks very realistic. I'm quite impressed. Also, the horn outside doesn't sound like that. But livery is actually one of the best bits, I think. They've made it look very good and very realistic. And for all the liveries and all of the costumes, they've made it look really good. I'm really pleased with it, as well as it's my local train. I want it to look good. Now, it should only take me 20-ish minutes to get to Nottingham. But, I'll say, I'll probably get to get a road signal or something. Interior also looked great. I mean, I've never been on a Midland Main Line train, as in the actual company Midland Main Line, so I don't know what the maquette was like, but it's pretty convincing. Sidings with one sad lonely 222. And also, I am pretty sure that a class 222 has never been to Barnsley. 222's never been to Barnsley, as far as I know. If I'm wrong, you'll probably shout at me in the comments. So I'm looking forward to that. But the actual scenery and sidings and depot look really realistic. I mean, it's a bit empty. There's supposed to be loads of trains here, but it's still very good. Now, we're stopping at Long Eaton and Beeston, and then Nottingham, where we finish. So, we're not stopping too much. We're not stopping at Spondon or Attenborough. So it shouldn't take too long. You can see Spondon, it's not far away. We've got a speed limit of 80 coming up, and a speed limit of 100, so that's fun. The interior sounds are actually very good. Right, there goes the speed limit of 80. Power up. Yeah, this train looks very realistic. I'm very pleased. It sounds alright. I think it's more when it's stationary that the sounds aren't as good, in my opinion. And when it's departing from zero, they're missing a certain sound. It almost sounds like a train dragon. It's a weird sound. I can't really describe it or do it. Sounds like a chain almost getting stuck. If I have footage, I'll put it in, but I don't think I do. Yes, I have been train spotting here. And I did see 222s. And I also saw the Network Rail HST new measurement train as well, so that was fun. That was nice to see. Now, Spondon Station doesn't look the best in this game, I don't think. Oh yeah, sorry if the game's slightly laggy. Well, lots nothing to do about that. eaten. I don't know whether I'll stop there or not. We'll see. Slightly laggy, I mean very laggy. Sorry about that. Speed limit of 110, that's good. In real life, there isn't an intercity service from Derby to Nottingham. You'd get a regional train that probably stops at Long Eaton, Attenborough, Beeston and Nottingham and takes about half an hour. Whereas if they did do an intercity service from Nottingham to Derby, it'd take, I don't know, 15 minutes, provided the line wasn't clogged up with 153s or 156s or 158s or any regional train. I think the Class 222 should be on Stepford Express in Stepford County Railway. It'd be a great thing to have in the game. Cab light on. Trains always love floating things. They have floating station signs, float platform signs, and of course floating bridges. Amazing. This is the second time I've re-recorded this video, so let's hope... Well, it's the second take at recording this video, so let's hope I don't have to record it again. Spend a whole day just trying to record one video with my voice in it. Because the first time, the game volume was too loud, so you couldn't actually hear my voice. It was a bit like this, it was really quiet, and you couldn't hear it at all. It was really quiet. So I've turned the desktop audio down, and I've turned the microphone volume up a little bit, so it should be fine now. Right, we're not far away from Long Eaton now. I think, personally, the Class 222 is the second best train after the Intercity 125/HST/Class 255. Someone asks me what my favourite train is, I'll instantly say HST. Just because... Well, it's a bit rude not to, isn't it? Unless it's only Mallard, that's also rude not to say. But I think... Most iconic trains, the Rocket, the Mallard and the HST, and possibly the Azuma, but that's not fun. Oh, when I say Azuma, I do mean IEP, sorry. People are going to kill me now, aren't they? Here's Long Eaton. I came here for a trip report video on my channel. hour in like 0.4 miles. It's not going to happen. This train, I think, is one of the best just trains models and train add-ons. So it is, they've done a very good job. I'm really pleased with it. You may be able to update the sound a little bit, like this doesn't sound too realistic. But it's not too bad. It's definitely not spoiling it for me. I love this train. This is Attenborough Nature Reserve, and when you're walking around it you can see the trains going past, like this. I and here is Attenborough Station. Now down to here, it's very straight. Down to Nottingham from here, the track is very straight. It's not got many bends in it, so basically it just goes straight all the way. It's quite good. Which means you can go to 100 miles an hour on it, even though you're not supposed to. happened to your head? Neither of the horn sounds are right, unfortunately. But other than that, sounds are okay, apart from when the train is stationary at a station or departing from zero. Or accelerating from zero, as I should say. I'm going to accelerate a bit far away from Nottingham so far. Not even close. Overall, I'd rate Class 222 pack a 7.5 out of 10, and the Derby Nottingham Leicester pack, I think maybe an 8 or an 8.5 out of 10. But one of the things that spoil this pack, the route pack, is the floating signs, and sometimes the scenery's a bit off, but, you know, still great. I mean, is it worth however much it was? Was the train worth £18.69? I think more £15, to be honest. And the Derby Nottingham Leicester pack isn't worth £24.99. I think it's more the price of... I think it should be more around £18.99. Like the other one. Oh, hang on. Hey! You better just come to another. I think this is going to crash into me if I don't get over the track soon. Oh no, it's waiting for me, that's good. Hello. So the sound here for this train isn't realistic when it starts, unfortunately. Well, the big question, would I recommend you buying this train? Yes. Would I recommend you buying the route pack? Yes. It is a great, they're both great, and maybe not worth the price, but they're not worth much less. But if you think about it, the money we pay goes towards new packs. So, if they were all cheaper, probably the packs have been less often, and well, we like getting new packs from people, so we don't want that. So it is fair enough, but not £21.99 fair enough, if you know what I mean. Is that 156? Ah, it's an AP156. Hello. It's just me and the 156 here at the moment. And here is Nottingham. One of my favourite stations. So I've travelled from it since I was a baby. And I think this is one of the most realistic stations on this pack. One of my issues is the car park here. It's the wrong colour. It's supposed to be blue and grey, but instead of gold. But you know, they're probably limited to be honest. But oh well. Opening sounds very realistic though. But however, the doors open way too quickly. The animation needs to be a lot slower. Well, thank you all very much for watching this video, and I hope to see you all next time. Bye for now.